In this video, I'll cover how to start up a new project and turn a project into a central model. So to start a new project, go to the application menu, pull it down, choose new, and then roll over to project. If this is an OPN project, by default, you should be set to the W drive, the Revit content folder, and then project templates folder. And you're going to create a new project. If you aren't set to this file, you can always click the browse button next to it to locate the project templates folder. Click OK to open it up. Now, to turn this project into a central model means you're turning on work sets. It's work sets that allow multiple users to work in the same project. So to turn on work sets, go to the Collaborate tab and then click the work sets button. Doing this, you'll see a warning screen warning you that work sharing will be enabled and that all the content you have so far will be moved to a default work set. And also, it's essentially telling you there's no turning back. Once you create a project as a central model, you can't change it back to a non-central model, which is fine. Go ahead and click OK. And after a few seconds, you should see the work sets window up here. It's telling you the different work sets that have been created for the project and who's created them. You can see my name here. For now, go ahead and click OK. We're going to come back to this window. So at this point, you're going to want to go ahead and save the project and give it a name. So using the application menu, I'll pull down and choose Save As and then roll over to Project. Here, you'll want to save the project in the current drawings folder in the project folder. I don't have access to the server right now, so I'm just going to save it in a project folder I created on my desktop. So pretending that this is a project folder on the server somewhere, you're going to browse to that folder and then go to Options, located in the bottom right corner. Click on that. And here you want to set up how many backup copies you're going to make of the project. And as a general rule of thumb, you want one more backup copy than there are team members for the project. And the reason for that is it will save a backup copy for every team member plus one extra one to go back one more even further. Once you do, make sure in the options it says that it's going to make this a central file, and it should by default. And click OK. And give it a name. And the naming convention is project number. Then project name. Then A for the fact that it's an architecture, Revit architecture version, and then the version number it is. In this case, it's Revit 11, so A11. And since it's a central model, finish it with central. Then hit save. Once the project has been saved, you need to synchronize the project to itself. So in the top left corner, go ahead and click synchronize. And the synchronize window will appear. And depending on what you're doing in the project, more of these boxes will become available for you to check. Always check as many as possible. Here, I just have two boxes to check in this case. And click OK. Now that the project has been synchronized, I need to go back to the work sets window. So under the Collaborate tab, I'm going to choose work sets. And here, under the work sets dialog, where there was the owner name, which was me for creating them, and it said yes, make sure that the work sets are no longer editable. And this seems a little counterintuitive. You would think that if they were editable, that means that they're able to be changed, but it actually means the opposite. If this were to say yes, as in yes, it's editable, That means it's editable for me, the author, and that means it locks everybody else out. So long story short, just make sure that the worksets you've created are no longer editable so that no one is locked out of them. And after synchronizing, they are no longer editable, and so that's good. And I'll click OK. If I did have to change those to be no longer editable, I would then need to synchronize the project again. So again, I'll go ahead and click Synchronize and check as many boxes as I can and hit OK. After I've synchronized and saved it again, I want to go ahead and close out of this project, and now I want to create a local file for this project. So I'm going to go to the application menu and just say close. From here, I'll go back to the application menu, and I'm going to open this project up again and open it this time as a local file. So go to the big R, open project. I'm going to browse to it. In this case, it should be in the current drawings folder now as a central file. And once you select it, in the bottom of the window, automatically the option called create new local should be checked. If it's not, make sure that it's checked. Because from this point on, after you've created the project as a central file, you no longer want to work in it directly. You're instead working from your own local copy, and then any changes you make are going to be saved back and synced back into the central file. So I'm going to create a new local now, and by hitting open. So it should look just like the project before. And before I synchronize and save my local copy, I want to make sure to go ahead and link the Keynote template, the Keynote file, to this project. The Keynote file is a text file that needs to be linked into the project, and that's what serves as the list for all your keynotes. To find the Keynote file, you're going to go to the same folder where the project template is located. So that's the W drive, Revit content, and then project templates. From there, drag and copy it into your project folder, and in your current drawings folder, create a linked files folder. Creating a linked files folder is a convenient place to keep any linked backgrounds, CAD files that will be linked into your project, and your Keynotes file. Once you've copied and pasted in the Keynotes file, go ahead and rename it per your project. So I would name it project number, project name, and then keynotes. Once you've named this file, you'll want to link this text file back to your project. So to do that, go back to your project under the Annotate tab. Under the Keynote tool, pull down the tag tray and choose Keynote Settings. From here, the Keynote Settings window will pop open. And here you want to browse to that file now by clicking the Browse button, going to your project folder, and locating it there, and click Open. The path type should be relative, and the numbering method should be by keynote. Once it's set up, click OK, and now it's linked to your project. Now, when you're done working in your local file, always synchronize by clicking on the green button here, and check any boxes you can, and hit OK.